friends, welcome to my kitchen. Today I am here to share with you all a requested recipe. It's a traditional Bengali dish and it's a very famous among all of us. The name of the recipe is Muri Ghonto. So let's check out the ingredients that are required to make Muri Ghonto. So the main ingredient of this recipe is fish head. I have taken here katla fish head. You may also take rohu fish head. In order to make Muri Ghonto, we need a fish which is of a big size. So here I have taken a big size fish head, as you can see. Then we need chopped onion. Here I have taken one big size onion, garam masala powder, 2 to 3 slitted green chilies, ginger paste. Here I have taken 1 tablespoon of ginger paste, potato which I have cut into cubes, bay leaves, 2 bay leaves, 2 red chilies, whole spices, cumin seeds, salt, sugar, red chili powder, cumin powder, turmeric powder, ghee, cashew nuts and raisins, mustard oil, and here as you can see I have taken soaked Govindabhog chal, which is a variety of rice found in Bengal. It has a very nice smell. You can also use basmati rice or kalijira rice, which is popularly found in most of the parts in India. So the main ingredients of this recipe are the fish head and the soaked rice. You have to choose a good rice variety in order to make this dish. So let us begin. The first thing that we have to do is marinate the fish head with salt and turmeric powder. So here I am adding salt and some turmeric powder. Now I will marinate the fish with the help of my hand. As you can see, I have added 4 tablespoons of mustard oil in a pan. Now as the oil is hot, I will add the marinated fish head into it. Just add and cover it with the lid as it will crackle. Fry the fish nicely. So it is done. Now I will transfer it into a separate plate. In the remaining mustard oil, I will fry the potatoes that I have cut into cubes. If required, you can add some more oil. Now as the potatoes turns golden brown in color, I will transfer this into a plate. Now in the same oil, I'm going to add the bay leaves, the red chilies, and the whole spices, garam masala, and cumin seeds. Saute for some time. Now I will add the chopped onion into it. Now Now that you can see, the color of the onion has changed and it has become tender. I am going to add 1 tablespoon of ginger paste into it. Now I will add a very little amount of water so that the onion and the ginger paste doesn't get burned. Cook for a few seconds. Now it's time to add the soaked rice into it. Here I have taken 1/2 cup of rice. You can use according to your how much you need. According to the quantity you can use it. Frying the rice is a very important part of this recipe. As you can see, the quantity of oil is also more. More the oil, the taste will be better. I have added here 5 tablespoons of oil. Now, while frying the rice, I will add the cashew and raisins into it. Fry it along with the rice. Now gradually I am going to add the masalas into it. First of all, I will use turmeric powder. Red chili powder. Cumin powder. And salt according to taste. And then I am going to add the green chilies into it. If you want, you can avoid the adding of cashew nuts and raisins. I use it as I like its flavor and taste. This gives a rich taste to the normal dish. Now it's time to add the potatoes into it. After adding the potatoes, I will add the fish into it. Mix all the ingredients very nicely. You can break the head of the fish with the help of the spatula. Now as it is nicely done, now I am going to add water into it. After adding water, as the water starts boiling, lower the flame of the gas and cover it with a lid and cook for 10 minutes. After 10 minutes, I will remove the lid. Now I am going to add sugar into it. This dish will be good and taste good if you add the quantity of the sugar more in comparison to other dishes. After adding sugar, I will add garam masala powder into it. Mix it well. As you have seen, I have added not much water as I don't want the rice to be overcooked. Add water how much is required. Now again I will cover it with a lid and cook for 5 to 10 minutes. So I am back after 10 minutes. Now as you can see, the rice is also nicely cooked and the potatoes are also cooked. Now in the final touch, I am going to add 1 tablespoon of ghee into it. So our today's recipe is done. Now I will turn off the gas and we can now serve it. So here comes our today's recipe, Muri Ghonto. Please try it at home. I'm sure you're going to love it. Though it takes a long time, still at the end it will be a finger-licking dish. If you like my video, please like, share and subscribe to my channel. And don't forget to click on the bell button to get regular updates. Thank you for watching my video. I will be back soon with the new recipe. Bye-bye.